But we begin tonight with the sort of news that is horrific and heartbreaking. The death of a little boy who, in the blink of an eye, ran onto the road and lost his young life. It happened at Kings Grove in Sydney Southwest, and that's where Andrew Denny is tonight for us. Andrew, walk us through the sad circumstances that led to this little boy's death.
Well, Sandra, a mother was walking her young children to school this morning when, at this intersection, her five-year-old boy was hit by a car. He was rushed to hospital, but he couldn't be saved. His name was Kevin Defelice, and he was taken far too young. It was a morning walk to school this family had made so many times before.
I hear the noise of the mother cry, screaming, you know, and I come out, for a lot of people up there.
Her five-year-old son was hit by a four-wheel drive, pinned under the front wheels. Watching on, the boy's young brother and sister and two other children inside the car.
He was trapped under the vehicle, was released, treated by ambulance crews quickly on the scene, an urgent transport to St George Hospital, suffering from what appeared to be neck head injuries.
Doctors tried to revive little Kevin, but he couldn't be saved. Flowers now mark the place his short life ended.
I saw the pram falling over. At first I thought maybe something happened to the baby. Then I saw the bigger boy just gone.
Police are trying to figure out if the boy ran into the path of the car or if the driver wasn't paying attention.
This type of thing is very distressing at any time. Even more so as we're getting near Christmas, it affects everybody.
His schoolmates were told the news this afternoon. Counselling has been offered to students and teachers. The car will now be taken away for a full mechanical inspection while police await the results of the driver's mandatory drug and alcohol tests. And with the school holidays approaching, police are pleading for everyone to pay extra attention.
Slow down, keep your eyes open, watch what you're doing, and for parents, keep an eye on your children.
Now, both Kevin's mother and siblings, as well as the driver, who is a parent herself, they were all taken to hospital where they were treated for shock. This all happened just a few hundred metres from the school where the boy attended, and that school community really is coming together to support this family. We've seen students lay flowers here this afternoon, and that support really is something this family will need in the days, months and years ahead. Sandra.
Thanks, Andrew. A difficult and sad day for so many.